Nityanandam. You are watching NTV News live from Dhyanapeetham Ashram here in Bidadi. It's Monday, January 17, 2011. Today's headlines: Annamalayar deity visits Dhyanapeetham Ashram in Thiruvannamalai. NNLP starts today at Dhyanapeetham Ashram. Abhishekam to Sri Anandeshwara performed today. Online webinars go on throughout the day. Swamiji is still away at Thiruvannamalai, where he conducted the last rites of his grandmother on January 14th. And he's very busy right now taking care of some administrative matters in Thiruvannamalai. So this morning at the Dhyanapeetham Ashram here, Pratyaksha Pada Puja was offered by the Ashramites to Swamiji's Padukas, where Ashramites offered their gratitude to the divine lotus feet of their Guru. Earlier today, we received news from Thiruvannamalai that today was a big day there with the Annamalayar deity, which is the Utsav Murti of the main deity in Sri Arunachaleshwara Temple. Paid a visit to the Dhyanapeetham Ashram in Thiruvannamalai while going on a procession around the city. We'll be providing you with more details in tomorrow's news. In other news from the ashram, a 3-day NNLP Enlightening Nityananda Neuro-Linguistic Program started at the Dhyanapeetham Ashram today. This program is designed to help us transform our limitations and experience a groundbreaking shift in the way we relate with ourselves and with others. The program works with word patterns and language structures, combining practical eye-opening techniques and games and profound spiritual truths. As always, today being Monday, Abhishekam or Holy Bath was performed to Sri Anandeshwara, the presiding deity of our Sri Anandeshwara Temple here at Bidadi Ashram. Abhishekam, or the holy bath of the deities, ended with a beautiful alankar or decoration. Online webinars were going on throughout the day. Ashramites were sharing their experiences on living in the presence of an enlightened master. Also, we would like to highlight Ma Bhakti Maya's talk on Guru Gita. It's a beautiful talk. You should not miss it. She's going to be talking 3 times in a week. One will be in Tamil and the other 2 days she'll be talking in English. That's all for tonight. Let's end the news with a quote from Swamiji. Just be in the present and allow the time to flow through you. Thank you for joining us and stay tuned to NTV News right here for more updates. Nityanandam.
Nityanandam, in today's episode on exploring the Vedic tradition, let us look into another aspect or cultural practice among the Hindus. Many of you might have witnessed women, Hindu women particularly, wearing bindi or sindura on their forehead. That will be a patch of a dot of color powder applied on their forehead. There are different ways in which people, Hindus particularly, apply marks on their forehead. What is the cultural basis for this practice? This practice, as you can see from the Vedic times, it has been prevalent and it is still practiced by most Hindu women. The practice of applying kumkum, that is the name of that bindi. Kumkum is a colored powder which is mixed with turmeric and applied on the forehead just between the two eyebrows. The basic reason for that is, spiritually and religiously, this nerve center where forehead joins with the eyebrows. That is termed as the seat of Ajna Chakra. Ajna Chakra is the chakra, when it is opened, gives you a connection to the conscious state. There are more than 5,000 meditation techniques just to open that chakra, Ajna Chakra. And you might have also seen the figure of Lord Shiva with three eyes, two of the normal eyes and the third eye is portrayed in that forehead region. That is not just an eye for Shiva alone. All the human beings have the eye of wisdom in that position. That is how the ancient literatures describe. And that is a position, when awakened, help you to connect with the divine consciousness. And that is also the place from where more of heat energy is emanated. So the body will be heated when that third eye is opened. So in order to cool that, it is advised to apply the cooling powder of that kumkum and the turmeric on the forehead. You might have also heard that kumkum is applied by women who are married, and those who have become widows remove it. That has also been a practice in this country. You might have also seen many women who are married, particularly in North India, they wear sindoor or the dark kumkum on their parting of the hair. That incidentally is a cultural practice and prevalent among married women. There is a ceremony in the marriage wherein the husband applies the sindoor or the kumkum on the parting of the woman to show that they have connected with each other. That is a symbol of a married woman. And in ancient times, socially also, women applying that were had safety from other elements who had evil eyes on them. So it was a social come spiritual practice among the Hindus and is still followed in many parts of this country and many parts of the world. Any Vedic custom has a significance based on spirituality. It is always aims at uplifting the human state to connect with the divine conscious state. Nityananda.